This kit is called LPG CNG gas leakage sensor kit. So whenever we have any leakage at home or at any commercial place, whenever we have a gas leakage, so this kit is built or made in order to detect the gas detection or the gas leakage. And also there's a motor attached here. So this will be attached to the knob of the gas cylinder. So as soon as this gas sensor detects any gas leakage, this particular motor starts rotating and closes the knob of the gas cylinder. So we'll show you the demo using a lighter. So as you can see, when the gas from the lighter is subjected to the gas sensor, it detects the gas, and as soon as it detects the gas, there's an alarm which is raised through the buzzer, and also the motor starts rotating. I'll show you again. Again, you can see the alarm was raised, and at the same time, simultaneously, the motor started rotating. So this is how the gas leakage detection system works. So you can order this kit from our site, kitscrew.com, where you'll get two versions of the kit. One is where you'll get this complete ready-made kit, which you can see here. And the other one is where you'll get all the components separately. And with the help of our video tutorials, you'll be able to assemble those components and test the kit by yourself. In this section of the video, we'll see what all components are used in this kit and what are the functions of each component and how do we assemble those components on the PCB and then how do we check the power supplies of each and every PCB here. So as you can see, we have a ready-made kit here for reference, and with the help of this kit, with the reference of this kit, we'll be assembling this kit by ourselves. So as you can see, there are three PCBs here. One is the main PCB, which is the PCB for the microcontroller. The other one is the gas. This is the main PCB. This one is the gas leakage sensor PCB, and this one is the motor driver circuit. So we'll start off with the assembly of the main PCB. So this is the blank PCB, and this is the top side where we insert all the components, and this is the bottom side where the copper tracks are present. So the technology that we use is called a through hole technology, in which we drill holes throughout the PCB and we insert the components from the top and then solder them at the bottom. For reference purpose, I'll keep this PCB in line with the ready-made kit so that we can we'll be able to know the alignment, proper alignment and direction of each and every component. Starting off with the power supply, first you can see we have provided the power supply here with the help of a jack, power jack. So this is a power jack. Then we have an on-off switch. So this controls the power supply to the kit. Okay. Then we have to insert a bridge rectifier. So in case you supply power through a transformer, you need to convert the AC supply into DC supply. For that, we use a bridge rectifier. Now this has four terminals, two AC input and two DC output. So the stem which is longest in length is the positive DC output. So while inserting the bridge rectifier, we need to ensure that the positive terminal is at the bottom right corner. So as you can see, the positive terminal is at the bottom right corner, and here also, and in line with the positive terminal of the bridge rectifier, we need to connect the positive terminal of the electrolytic capacitor. So this is an electrolytic capacitor. The stem which is longer in length is the positive terminal. In case both the stems are of equal length, there's a strip on the capacitor which indicates that is a negative terminal. So while inserting, we have to ensure that the positive terminal is in line with the positive terminal of the bridge rectifier. Then we have to use two voltage regulator ICs, because this entire kit runs on 5 volts. All the components run on 5 volts. So we need to convert the power supply to a smooth 5 volts output. For that, we use this voltage regulator IC 7805. So this is the front face. The stem which is at the left is the first stem, then ground, then the output. So as you can see, there are two voltage regulator ICs used. One will be inserted with the front face facing towards you, and the other face and the other one will be inserted with the third stem facing towards you. So as you can see, this is the third stem which is facing you. Then we need to connect a 2-pin connector base. So this acts as the power supply for this motor driver IC or motor driver circuit. And then we use a power indicator LED. As you can see, when LED has two terminals, positive and negative, stem which is longer in length is a positive terminal. In case both the stems are of equal length, the LED bulb is round in shape, but at the negative terminal it gets flat. So the bulb will be flat at the negative terminal. So while inserting the LED, we have to ensure that the negative terminal is towards the right side. And along with the LED, we provide a resistor of 1K, color code brown, black and red. This is to protect the LED. Then we'll come on to the section of the microcontroller. So this is a base, IC base, and this is the main microcontroller. So as you can see, there's a notch which is present. So the pin which is at the top left is the pin number 1, and then we need to count the number of pins counterclockwise. So the pin which is at the top right is the pin number 40. So before inserting the microcontroller, we'll have to insert the base. This is to protect the microcontroller in case of soldering, or also if you need to change the microcontroller in future, you can do that. So even this IC has a base as a notch, so which has to be present on the right side. As you can see, the IC base is present on the right side. So the microcontroller will be inserted over the base like this, and the notch will be present on the right side. So this microcontroller works on a clock frequency of 10 megahertz. So we insert this crystal oscillator. And to start the oscillation process, we use two capacitors of 33 picofarad in parallel. Then we insert a micro switch to reset the microcontroller. And along with that, to pull down the micro switch, we use a resistor of 10K with color code brown, black and orange. And then we'll come to the next microcontroller, the LM324 driver IC. So first we'll insert the IC base. So this IC base has a notch on the left side. So first we'll insert the base, and then we'll insert the driver IC over it with the notch on the left side. And then we'll connect a potentiometer. So this is a 10K potentiometer. This is to change or adjust the sensitivity of the gas sensor. And along with that, we have to insert a 3-pin connector base. So this 3-pin connectors are used for two as a power supply and one for the data. So as you can see, the three wires going, two are for the power supply and one is for the data. So then after that, as you can see, there are a number of resistors here. So these are of 10K, so you can insert all of them as provided. And then there's another potentiometer here. So this is to adjust the resolution of the LCD screen. So you can change the value by using a screwdriver. Insert the screwdriver into the potentiometer and then rotate it to change the value analog in analog way. And then there's a 4-pin connector base here, as you can see. So this is to run the motor driver. And then there is an LCD screen. So first we'll connect the base. This is a male bud strip. And then the female bud strip is inserted onto the LCD and then soldered, and then it has to be inserted over the male bud strip. So this has to be inserted in exactly the same way. You don't have to, you cannot or you should not insert it in the opposite direction. It should not be inserted like this. It should be inserted like this outwards. So once this main PCB is completed, we'll assemble the components on the PCB of the gas sensor. So there are not many components here. You can see there's a gas sensor, so you just have to insert the gas sensor here and then the 3-pin connector. So the 3-pin connector has to be connected here, and along with that there are two resistors of 10k and 2.2k. So this is 10k and this is 2.2k, so that will be provided to you. So once you have finished assembling both the PCBs, we'll check the power supply. To check the power supply, we use a digital multimeter. So this is a digital multimeter. The black terminal is the ground terminal, which has to be connected to the body of the voltage regulator IC. So pin number 40 of the microcontroller should show 5 volts. Then the positive pin here, that is the power supply which is going to this IC, motor driver IC, the positive should show the input supply. As you can see, we have given an adapter, so the input power supply is around 12 volts, so that has to be present here. And in the same way here also, you can see there are two terminals, one will be 5 volts, the other will be 12 volts. So you need to connect the 12 volts here, the positive supply here, to the positive supply here. So as you can see here, on the left side there's a positive supply, and here on the right side there's a positive supply, or the bottom side there's a positive supply. And also the second last pin and the second pin should show 5 volts at the LCD. And this is a buzzer, so you have to connect the buzzer. And while connecting the gas sensor, we have to ensure that one pin is positive. So the center one will be positive. As you can see, at the input the center one is positive, which is getting around 5 volts. Here also the input at the center should be 5 volts, that is positive. And then at the left side is ground. As you can see, the left side is ground, and here the top side is ground, and then the right and the bottom, or the third pin, is the data pin. So once you have checked the power supplies and finished your connections, and after the soldering is done, you can proceed to fix all the microcontrollers and ICs. So you can order this kit from our site, kitsguru.com, where you will get two versions of the kit. One is where you will get all the whole kit, complete kit, working kit. And the other one is where you will get all the components separately. And with the help of our video tutorials, you will be able to assemble those components together.